That update on that insight. Right now, we want to go to this Sky News 6 shot. Tulsa police officers with guns drawn are on the roof of the building there near 61st and Yale, obviously being very cautious as they search for any possible second gunman. We understand the gunman has been shot. We don't know if that was by police, self-inflicted, or by maybe somebody who was in that facility in the Natalie building, but you can see officers right now very carefully with their weapons drawn.
Going on from our point of view, there's police vehicles here, and there's actually even more just over top of the hill as you get closer to the scene itself. But we just got an update moments ago. We're told officers received the call just after 4:50, and they responded within about 3 minutes. That's when officers encountered the suspect and the victims on the second floor, which is where the scene itself is. There is an orthopedic office on that floor. Tulsa police have said that 4 innocents were killed, which could be a combination of staff and patients here. They're still working that situation out. And the shooter was also found dead with a self-inflicted gunshot wound, bringing that death toll to 5 total people. The shooting itself lasted roughly 5 minutes, and no officers were injured. And the suspect is said to be a black male between 35 and 40 years old, or in that age range, who had one long gun and a handgun. And it is believed that both of those weapons were used in this particular incident this afternoon. We'll be sure and keep you updated as more information is released throughout the night. Reporting in Tulsa, Austin Brissett, back to you.
At 4:52 hours, our dispatch received a call of an active shooter at the Natalie Medical Building at 6457 South Yale Avenue. We had officers arrive at the location at 4:56, so a 3-minute response time, and made contact with victims and the suspect at 5:01, and that was them making their way to the second floor. The officers that did arrive were hearing shots in the building, and that's what directed them to the second floor. Right now we have 4 civilians that are dead. We have 1 shooter that is dead, and right now, we believe that is self-inflicted. Officers have not been interviewed, but we're certain that's a self-inflicted gunshot wound on his part. The scene is fairly limited to 1 section of that floor, on the second floor, and officers are currently, and detectives, interviewing witnesses that were throughout the building, and especially those on the second floor. No officers were injured. We have a reunification center set up at Memorial High School in the auditorium on the north end of Memorial High School for families that may have had somebody in this building at the time and have not been able to make contact. That is a location they can check in with for information. Right now, the suspect, we do not have an identity. That we believe we're getting close on the identity of the suspect. He is a black male, estimated to be 35 to 40 years old, and we have confirmed he had 1 long gun, a rifle, and 1 handgun on the scene at the time.